21 to the World Wrestling Federation Superstars of Wrestling at ringside. This is Vince McMahon along with wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino. And yes, one Jesse the Body Ventura as well. We have lots of excitement for you this week. Fasten your seatbelt. Here we go. Personified Coco Beware. Also scheduled this week, the new dream team, whatever that may be, we'll find out from Johnny V. And then from there, we know all about this extraordinary tag team of the Rougeau brothers. And then from there, from Memphis, Tennessee, to join us will be the Honky Tonk Man. All of those and more. But right now, we take you to some of the recent incidents of just last week involving one Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
April 25th, the World Wrestling Federation will be making an appearance in Port Jervis, New York.
A big crowd coming to the Fort Jervis High School, sponsored by the class of 1987. They've signed up Big Black Jack Mulligan, the Magnificent Morocco, Ace Cowboy Bob Orton, and the Birdman Coco Beware, among others, in Fort Jervis, New York, at the high school gym of WWF, Saturday, April 25.
And he's definitely hit high. Jimmy Jack's got to take advantage of it right here and do the damage.
Well, that's the kind of style Coco Beware has. It's a very dangerous kind of style.
Ooh. Oh.
When Coco makes a mistake, it's going to be a big one.
That's right. He did it. What a close one across that top rope. Beautiful move on the part of Coco.
Jimmy Jack moving back in. Jimmy Jack with a brawling tactics and now slowing down Coco Beware.
That's the key. You got to move. Raked his eyes right along the top rope. I love it. That's a move I made famous.
Frankie cocking his head there. Wants to see a little turnabout here, and he's not going to get it. As Jimmy Jack a moment ago again set up Coco Beware.
Better, we have one. We get two.
Oh, no. Coco back to his feet. And oh, no, look at that. Coco put on the break.
From the pages of the WWF magazine, here's an update with Craig DeJord.
Hi, everyone. We have tag team news for you. Mr. Fuji has done it again. Now managing not only Morocco and Orton and Kamala and Sika, but also Demolition. And Axe and Smash are telling opponents to get out of the way or else.
The reason why Axe and myself were put on this earth is to demolish people. And it doesn't matter where or when our new manager tells us to demolish them, we do. Isn't that right?
All we have to do to be successful is demolish people. All we have to do to be successful is pay attention to our new manager. That means Rougeau's, Can-Am Connection, Hart Foundation. It doesn't matter who steps in our way. You're going to go down because we want to be the number one tag team in professional wrestling. And nobody, absolutely nobody, is going to stand in our way.
Very, very true, Demolition. You make a opponent suffer. You will tear into the body. You will make the bones crackle, crackle one piece at a time under guidance of Mr. Fuji.
All right, Mr. Fuji may look different now, but remember, beneath that makeup is still the same wicked, but most often victorious man. As for his tag team Demolition, frankly, they are scary and certainly a major contender for the tag team title. With update, I'm Craig DeJord.
Introducing to my right, at a total combined weight of 507 pounds, from Lenexa, Kansas, Tommy Sharp. His partner from Vancouver, British Columbia, Nick Kiniski. Their opponents are managed by Johnny B. And ladies and gentlemen, here is Johnny B's new dream team. At a total combined weight of 496 pounds from Seattle, Washington, Greg the Hammer Valentine. And from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, Dino Bravo. goodness. The New Dream Team. Outfit conspicuously after the place. There's one Brutus Beefcake. Excommunicated from the Dream Team.
Is that what happened?
I'll say that and a whole lot more. Johnny V with his New Dream Team. Johnny V, very, very busy.
I love Johnny V's socks. You check out them socks he's had.
Johnny V very busy these days with his New Dream Team. As a matter of fact, Johnny V so busy that as we heard earlier on, he has sold the contract of the demolition to Mr. Fuji.
I'm not sure that was a good move.
Look at this, Nick Kaninsky. Fine looking at him. Contract takes out. Drop kick. Whoa! Kaninsky moving in. Johnny V, as a matter of fact, was asked about the transaction with the demolition and the New Dream Team. Here's what he had to say.
Beefcake will never forgive you what you've done to Adrian Adonis. Let me tell you something. Dino Bravo, you're not half the man what Dino Bravo is. You're on the outside looking in, baby. It's the New Dream Team, and you're not part of it.
No, indeed. Beefcake not part of the New Dream Team.
Definite hostilities. Amazing how quickly that whole thing came about.
Tag is made. Tommy Sharp coming in. And thus far, I don't know about you, but I'm impressed with Nick Kaninsky. We'll see how he and Tommy Sharp can function as a group.
Well, Nick Kaninsky's young, he's big, he's strong, he's aggressive, and he's looking to climb the ladder.
Tommy Sharp off the rope. The Hammer dropped the elbow a moment ago.
And a win over the New Dream Team would be considered a major upset.
Greg the Hammer.
Personally, I think with Bravo in there now instead of Beefcake, they do possess possibly a little more strength.
Yes, I'd have to agree with that. Bravo, what a... The New Dream Team, I guess, means that... Take a look at the hairdo on Bravo. He had, just last week, as I recall, dark hair.
Yes, he did. Boom! He's an Italian blonde now. I suppose we'll see Bruno dye his hair by next week.
Then how about the Hammer tagged in? Off the rope. And the elbow drop. Greg the Hammer.
And he measured him with that one.
The Hammer trying to set up Tommy Sharp. Up in the air.
Yes.
You can bet there aren't too many fans that count Greg the Hammer or the New Dream Team in the fan club of the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, like them or not, you know, they're an awesome team. Like I said, Bravo, extremely powerful.
Look at that.
And Johnny V's brought out this aggressiveness in Dino Bravo. You know, a couple years ago, Bravo was very passive in the ring. And now he's aggressive, he's looking to win. And I like that. I like to see that.
Johnny V hoping that the New Dream Team is going to be on the cover of the WWF magazine. I don't think he's going to make it myself. Tommy Sharp. In the air, and again,
look at the strength.
Yes, you alluded to that earlier on as Bravo.
Oh, man.
Tommy Sharp out of the camp.
He could get him right here.
Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. Valentine was standing right there, and the referee continued the count.
He didn't do anything.
He wasn't supposed to be in the ring.
Hammer just
here on the winner, the New Dream Team, quick by Hammer Valentine and Dino Bravo.
The Hammer probably just wanted a closer look at that move.
Oh, I see. All right, Johnny V with a victory here for the New Dream Team. All right, little kiss coming your way, Jesse. We'll go back to the replay.
No question about the New Dream Team is an exceptionally powerful one. Look at this. You see Bravo slamming this shot through that mat to home down to final three. Johnny V gets up. Really an awesome team here in the Dream Team.
Johnny V and the New Dream Team. Bravo, Valentine. Victorious here. We'll have more action from inside after this special interview.
All right, we're going to be back out on Long Island. Fans here in New York, the Nassau Coliseum, Friday night, May 1st. Phenomenal World Wrestling Federation card. New Intercontinental Champion, Ricky Steamboat, in a 15-foot-high steel cage to be challenged by former champion, Macho Man Randy Savage. British Bulldogs will be challenging the Hearts for their titles. Danny Davis barred from the building. Santana and Reed collide head-on. Jimmy Hart, come on in. Brutus Beefcake will be meeting your man with certainly a new look, you'd have to say, Adrian Adonis.
You know, when this is over, Brutus, you're going to have a new look, and that's a promise.
Adrian Adonis, you're the man that felt the wrath of the scissors in WrestleMania 3 at the hands of Brutus Beefcake, your opponent, here on May 1st, the Nassau Coliseum.
I want to explain something to all you people out there. You know, like when a guy goes to the can and they work him over day after day, take his lunch in, his meals, and then all of a sudden he just picks up a pipe and bashes somebody's skull in. The people understand in his eyes he does not care anymore. There's no more rules. He has nothing to live by. He's got to make a reputation. Brutus tried to make the reputation. That's going to stop there. And I'm the one that's got the pipe. And I'm the one that's going to bash your brains. I'm the one that's going to inflict violence, which a banquet which I feed from, and it's going to go down and down into your crawl until you can't take it no more. You're not even going to get up. You're not even going to see the daylight and watch that sun rise, because you're never going to see it again. I can guarantee it. It's just a fact, Jack. There's no brag involved in it. You humiliated me when Piper was going down, and I cannot stand it. I cannot live with my soul. I cannot live with myself, and you've got to pay. You listen to the band, you gotta pay the man.
All right, what a shootout that should be. Part of the action at the Nassau Coliseum Friday night, May 1st. Adrian Adonis to meet Brutus Beefcake. Don't miss it.
Out of the World Wrestling Federation, making welcome, of course, to Leaping Lanny Poffo. Here with us this week, and Mr. Cosby Crowd, and earlier on, he recited a little poem. We have it for you.
Hello, wrestling fans. It's Leaping Lanny on the air with another way to meet your favorite stars. Life has many sweet rewards, but take a look at this. World Wrestling Federation ice cream bars.
Let's go to ringside. This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from Miami, Florida, weighing 257 pounds, Jim Young. And his opponent, to be led towards the ring by his manager, Colonel Jimmy Hart, from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing 245 pounds, the Honky Tonk Man.
What is that? That's his fan, the DDT. And I got to agree with Jimmy Hart. I think the DDT should be banned.
You've got to be kidding me. Look at the Honky Tonk Man with his guitar.
You know, the guy looks so much like Elvis, I can't believe it.
Really?
I mean, isn't it great to have Elvis reincarnated right before your very eyes? He's better looking.
One man's opinion. Jimmy Hart will assign down the DDT.
But it's my opinion, the one that counts.
Why should the DDT be banned?
Why? Well, if you look close, when Jake the Snake puts the DDT on, he'll generally grab a handful of hair before he drives it down into the mat. That makes it illegal.
It's not illegal, though.
It should be illegal.
A Honky Tonk Man may think that one of those DDTs has his name on it. That's perhaps why he wishes to have the DDT banned. Earlier on, as a matter of fact, Jimmy Hart had a few comments about his crusade, I guess you would have to say, to ban the DDT. Here's what Jimmy Hart had to say.
You know, starting a campaign out there to ban the DDT is the most vicious hook in professional wrestling, and it should not be used in the professional wrestling ring. And all you fans out there that are fans of Honky Tonk Man, you write in and you let us know what you think, too. Ban the DDT.
Ban the DDT. Give me a break. DDT, a legal maneuver, a devastating maneuver. As a matter of fact, I think a lot more devastating than the shake, rattle, and roll that we see Honky Tonk do from time to time.
Well, that might be, but I'll tell you what, if Jimmy Hart plays his politics right and gets the DDT banned, where is that going to leave Jake the Snake?
Jake the Snake is an individual. Oh, look at this.
I mean, Jake totally relies on the DDT. If Jimmy manages to get that taken away, it's going to be like Jake the Snake will only be half the wrestler that he was. Or is.
Elbow to the back of the head.
Do you agree?
No, I totally disagree. I think that Jake the Snake is one of the more versatile wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation today. Honky Tonk out.
Yeah, I don't know why I asked.
Way outside. Come on. Honky Tonk stepping in the throat a moment ago of young Jimmy Young. Ooh, what a right hand. Honky Tonk with Jim Young rolls him back in.
Well, I'll tell you, you may not like this guy, but he gets the job done. He's effective.
Honky Tonk ramming his forearms moment ago. And look
Look at the fans, how they love this guy.
I can't believe that he still thinks that some of the fans support him. Jim Yost.
Ooh, what a clothesline. My goodness.
I got to give up to the honky-tonk man. Great sense of timing there.
Definitely, this guy's well schooled.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Shape. Here's the rattle. And look out.
There's...
Whoa! Boy, did he ever roll it.
Whoa, he snapped that neck on the mat. He's got the three-pound lead. Yes.
Listen to this roar. What booze. The winner of this contest, the Honky Tonk Man.
This guy's the most gracious winner in wrestling. Never see another wrestler thank the man.
I know you're behind me 100%. I love every one of you.
Is he kidding?
I know this is what you want. I'm not going to disappoint you. So turn the Honky Tonk Man's music on. You want to see me dance? You want to hear me sing?
Give me a break. Honky Tonk Man. Jimmy Hart, hoping the band to DDT.
Look at those moves.
Let's catch up with another superstar in the WWF.
All right, fans, we're going to be back midtown at Madison Square Garden Monday night, May the 18th. Phenomenal card. Hulk Hogan to meet Harley Race for the heavyweight title. Jake the Snake, come on in if you would. Jake Roberts here in New York City on May the 18th in a rematch of sorts from WrestleMania 3. You're going to be meeting the Honky Tonk Man, and I like that leather. You know how I feel about leather.
I do know how you feel about leather. I've seen those riding crops you carry around for them riding that you do at night. You know, I heard you're a night rider. Is that right?
Anyway, the Honky Tonk...
You ride some big ones, but I'll tell you something, Honky Tonk. Some people never get enough of some things, right?
That's correct.
I mean, there's some things in life you hunger for, man. Whether it be food, or a woman, or a place and time. The place and time for me is May 18th. Where? Madison Square Garden. Downtown, man. We're talking the city where they do anything. For fun. Just for fun. Well, Honky Tonk Man, I ain't having no fun. I don't feel good. I might be smiling, but sometimes I just use that to cover up what I really feel inside.
You know, the one thing, Jake Roberts, that I admire about you, you take your time. Certainly, patience is a virtue, and you have patience.
Beware the fury of a patient man, Gene, because, you know, although I do sit back and smile sometimes, I'm not smiling inside. All I'm doing is waiting for that right opportunity to do what I do best, and that's hooking somebody's head and driving them to the mat. Now, you know, I do that with one arm. Can you imagine what I can do with two hands if I ever get a hold of you, Honky Tonk? You're fast, but you can't run forever. And when I catch you, my man, I'm going to have my way with you.
All right. Thank you very much. He is Jake the Snake Roberts, slated to meet the Honky Tonk Man as part of the action at Madison Square Garden here in the Big Apple on Monday night, May the 18th. By the way, Coco Beware to meet Danny Davis, the Rougeaus, also on the card.
Contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing to my right, from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, at a total combined weight of 489 pounds, Jacques and Raymond, the Rougeau brothers. Their opponents, at a total combined weight of 486 pounds, from Tampa, Florida, Terry Gibbs. And his partner from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, Bill Howard.
Howard and Gibbs against the fabulous Rougeau brothers. How do you like those jackets? Yes, sir, they're gorgeous. They're gorgeous. You know what the best part is? I can finally know which Rougeau's which, because they got their names on them. So I got that straightened out now.
I see.
Raymond's the one with the mustache.
That's right.
So then reducing it a little bit further down, reducing it in how it logically
chops the one without the mustache.
Just
the one in the ring.
Just wanted to hear you say it.
I do my homework.
Yes, you do. Tiger's made now. Terry Gibbs coming into the ring. Jacques Rougeau ready for action. Rougeau.
And that's what you get for playing with fire. Look at these Rougeau brothers. You want to wrestle aggressively? They can do that. Look at that. Whoa, man. One, two, and almost three. Gibbs in the air. Bam. The guy Howard's in there. Maybe not for long.
And look at now. What's the other Rougeau running in there for?
What was the Howard running in there for? Rougeau's earlier on had a few peanut comments about beefcake, I believe. Not on your mind these days. Here's what the Rougeau brothers have to say.
We always told you people that Bravo was no good, but now you just brought out your true colors in what you did with beefcake.
And what you did to us in WrestleMania, somebody's going to pay some dues around here in Bravo and Valentine. You ain't no more Dream Team. You're going down, boys, when you face the Rougeau brothers.
John Kramer, a little angered, justifiably so. Nice maneuver.
Howard's trapped in the rope. Now the referee's got to get in there. Look at this
double. And John Jones in a chest. Raymond's going to try more of the same. Yes.
This is what the Rougeaus are great at.
Double drop kick.
Illegal double teaming in the ring.
Look at this. Oh, look at this maneuver. Howard. Oh, wow. Oh. One, two, you can count to 100.
Yeah. Some of the slickest double teaming I've ever seen that a referee has allowed them to get away with.
Oh, you're actually complimenting the Rougeau brothers.
The winners of this bout, the Rougeau brothers.
The fans certainly like them.
Hey, they broke the rules. They won the match. I give them credit for that.
All right, back to the replay. Bruno,
Rougeaus were great. Look at this fine system from the top rope. This Raymond Rougeau. Now here's Jacques.
Great technique now, ladies and gentlemen, standing by, Trent the George.
With him, the lovely Elizabeth. Let's find out what Elizabeth has to say.
All right, with me right now, of course, the lovely Elizabeth. But Elizabeth, I want to ask you about Macho Man Randy Savage. Just what is it like now dealing with him after losing the title belt?
Well, I have to tell you that I've never seen him like this before. He's gotten to the point where he's cruel. He's just possessed. He wants to regain this title so much. I don't know what to do. I've never seen him like this before.
Well, Elizabeth, a little upset, but I don't think our next guest is upset at all. As a matter of fact, we had an occasion to chit-chat with the lovely Bonnie Steamboat and the Dragon himself.
You know something, ladies and gentlemen, it seems as though on November the 22nd, suffering the injury at the hands of Randy Savage, that my life, my wrestling career was coming to an end. But on WrestleMania 3, March the 29th, victory could not be any sweeter, winning this championship from Randy Savage. And Bonnie, why don't you tell them the other good news?
Ricky and I are going to have a little dragon, so we have a dragon in the oven.
That's right. This is going to be the year of the dragon. Everything is coming together now. My life, my wrestling career, a family on the way. And Randy Savage, if you think for one moment, one split second, that you're going to be taking all this away from me, you are sadly mistaken. You are wrong. If you think that you can tear the heart and soul out of this body, it will never happen.
What we heard from the Dragon Ricky Steamboat only right now that we take you to the Macho Man. Yes, indeed. The Macho Man Randy Savage has an awful lot to say, visibly.
Okay, Randy Macho Man Savage is making his way toward the dressing room. We're going to try to get a word on what happened to Ricky the Dragon Steamboat at WrestleMania.
I'm not saying nothing to nobody. My comment is no comment.
All right, well, some have said that he will never regain the championship title that
what
he was.
What are you talking about never regain?
Some people...
You're out of line, man. You got a lot of gut. I'll tell you something right now. You want a comment, I'll give you a comment. The dragon will fall, oh yeah, real soon. Because I'll tell you something, I'm going to get that Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt back. No doubt about it. And don't you ever say nothing else against that. The press or anybody. Either my friend or my lunch, you get out of the way. Itsy bitsy dragon fans, get out of my way. I'm going to take the belt and there's nothing nobody can do about it. Get out!
Ladies and gentlemen, to the latest chapter in the story that indeed captured the imagination of everyone. It, of course, involves one Ken Patera, the first human being the military pressed 500 pounds above his head. He's something else. Let's take you now to the Ken Patera story.
Last week, we heard of Ken Patera's sensational amateur career, his Olympic medals, and his Pan Am victories. But after turning professional wrestler and working with Bobby Heenan, Ken Patera changed. The tragedy began when a fine Olympic athlete was swayed by the twisted, greedy mentality of one of the most manipulative managers in all of professional sports. Ken Patera signed with Bobby Heenan, but his golden image became immediately tarnished as he developed into one of the brain's most successful revenue-producing wrestlers. Heenan molded Ken Patera from Olympic athlete to bona fide monster.
I want that World Wrestling Federation belt around my waist. As everybody's quite aware of, I'm an uncrowned champion. Everybody knows that. Like Mr. Heenan mentioned earlier, I am undefeated.
Oh, no! Twisting, turning in midair as Ken Patera through.
I need this man more than anybody else in the world.
You're not going to insult me.
Where did all of this lead Ken Patera? To financial reward? Yes. To championship opportunities? Yes. But the vulnerability of this Olympian was overwhelming. He could not resist the money, the accolades, or the adulation. All of Heenan's efforts did not lead Ken Patera to the title, to respect, or to fulfill promises. No, it led Ken Patera to this.
But Ken Patera has something too bad. He was influenced by the brain, Bobby Heenan.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my left, the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. He represents, weighing 275 pounds, Hercules. His opponent, from Goodyear, Arizona, weighing 235 pounds, Billy Anderson.
You know, getting back, Vince, to that Ken Patera thing, see, that's the problem. You know, you talked about him being influenced by Heenan.
Yeah.
That's the problem with all amateur athletes. See, they're all totally influenced. They're told when to get up, when to go to bed, when to eat, when to train. None of them ever think for themselves as amateurs, and that's how they get in problems later in life.
Now, I think people get in problems later in life and indeed earlier in life, but just by listening to the likes of Bobby the Brain Heenan. Certainly, I know one individual that doesn't listen to Heenan, Billy Jack Haynes. Here's what he had to say earlier this week.
Hercules, you're rough, you're tough. Don't ever think for one second that in WrestleMania 3, I am going to forget about this. Brother, you go ahead. You bring that chain in the ring anywhere, anytime, any place, and one of them is seriously going to be hurt.
What a violent man he is.
Oh, wait a minute.
I mean, that guy gets out and makes threats of bodily harm, what he's going to do, this and that. Billy Jack Haynes, to me, is a loudmouth and a violent man. He's obviously got psychological problems. And
look at that.
There's problem for Billy Anderson. Nobody going to get out of that.
Well, Nelson applied and Anderson dumped down like a sack of potatoes as Bobby the Brain once again steps through the ropes. Another notch on the belt.
Look at the shape this guy's in.
Yeah, he is something else.
Look at him.
Here is your winner, Hercules.
Hercules with that chain. I wouldn't want to be on the other end of the chain if Billy Jack was there, I'll tell you that.
Well, I kind of wish he'd tie you up with that chain and teach you a little manners, too.
Look at this. Come on. Anderson to the outside. Some of the fans are out ringside chanting, Weasel. They do not like Bobby the Brain, nonetheless. Well, this is one of the most successful managers in professional
that's
wrestling.
That's right.
Today.
People are jealous of successful people.
I see. Back to the replay.
Well, we see Hercules completely demolish Billy Anderson and then wind up with that awesome full Nelson, which, of course, was no escape for Anderson, but to submit.
Look at the strength of Hercules. Indeed. Firstly, we're going to hear from Beefcake. Secondly, we're going to hear from Adonis. as this, of course, relates to WrestleMania. Now, here's Big Kick.
You know, Adrian Adonis, back when my mama was holding me in her arms, a little Brutus Beefcake, little did she know that one day her little Beefcake would be the one. He would be the chosen one to defrock you, to take your hair from your head in front of the world. Now I must go on. Now I must go on and take care of the rest of you.
All right, with me, of course, Jimmy Mathis of South Hart. We were supposed to also have Adrian Adonis. You're going to bring him on for us, and we want to ask him about the situation. Jimmy.
Adrian, come on out. Come on, Adrian. That's okay. Come on. Come on, Adrian. Yeah. Come on. Come on, Adrian. That's it, baby. That's it. Brutus, you thought you were cool, didn't you, Brutus? Beefcake, your moment. Two of you to hold this man down and shave his head. Well, baby, you ain't seen nothing yet. You're going to wish you were never born. That's right, Brutus. You're going to wish that you were never born, baby. That's a promise. That's a promise.
Certainly no love lost between Beefcake and Adonis.
This tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first to my right, at a total combined weight of 481 pounds, from Portland, Oregon, Rick Hunter. His partner from Antigua in the West Indies, SD Special Delivery Jones. Their opponents are managed by the Mountain of the South, Jimmy Hart. And also introducing Foundation member, Danny Davis.
What a reception for Danny Davis.
Here are the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions at a total combined weight of 515 pounds, the Hart Foundation.
Bret Hart, the Anvil, Jim Neidhart, the Hart Foundation still reigning as tag team title holders, but a lot of teams are gunning for them.
Oh, that they are. I'll tell you, though, they're good. You got to admit that, McMahon. The Hart Foundation, Jimmy Hart's got them primed, ready, defending those titles everywhere.
Why is Davis there?
Consultant.
Consultant?
Yeah, what better thing than to have a former referee to consult on things of, you know, rules and things like that outside the ring.
See, I don't think Danny Davis is going to be on the WWF Rules Committee. All right, that's Dave.
I'd put him on there before Jack Tunney.
Look at this, SD off the rope, underneath, and right back at him.
Oh, no.
SD caught with the clothesline.
SD walked right into the Anvil's clothesline.
Anvil clever. Look at this. All right, one, two, and oh, my. This is about as close as you can come to a pin. Two anxious moments there for Jimmy Hart.
Well, Anvil's caught in the wrong corner, but comes out with the big knee. Look at the strength of this guy. You know, he's agile, too. That's what makes him double trouble.
Yes, but the Harts are not nearly as agile as the Bulldogs. And when the Bulldogs have their turn at bat, so to speak, a lot of people think the Bulldogs are going to be reigning again as champions. Here's what they had to say.
You know, the real story about the Hart Foundation is written in the WWF magazine. Remember, Foundation, all three of us are watching you.
That includes Matilda, of course.
Yeah, but remember, talk is cheap.
The William Patterson College Recreation Center in Wayne, New Jersey will be the focal point for World Wrestling Federation action on Friday night, May 1st. Signed to appear include Haku and Tama, the Islanders, the ladies champion, the Fabulous Moolah, Jake the Snake Roberts, and Billy Jack Haynes, who looks forward to his contest in Wayne, New Jersey on Friday night, May 1st at the William Patterson College Recreation Center.
To the outside.
Now look how smart the Anvil is here. The Anvil ties up the referee inside the ring and allows the hitman to do the damage outside the ring, and then dumb old SD Jones comes in and allows him to do that much more damage.
I think somebody should grab the microphone.
See, that's technique in tag team wrestling. Distract that referee and then get your shot to him.
Rick Hunter just took a shot from the top rope. Now adding a little insult to injury, shouting at Rick Hunter, now reaching for the tag, and the hitman is back in.
Oh, and they're setting him up. They're setting him up.
Here goes Bret Hart. Yes. Wow.
all she wrote.
SD knocked through the rope by the Anvil moments ago.
There's Danny Davis in there. Come on, give me a break.
That's when Davis comes in.
Megaphone.
She won't let it go. The hard slap. Danny Davis almost tipped on the heels. Look at that. She got him. She got him. Matilda going after him.
You know, attack dogs like that should be muzzled. They should not be allowed in public.
The winners of this contest, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, the Hart Foundation.
And we've seen so many times, here's the most vicious clothesliner in professional wrestling today. And again, we've seen it displayed, and here's Bret Hart pinning Rick Hunter.
Well, standing by, as we said earlier on, the Bulldogs, they had their eyes on the Harts, and my goodness, did they ever. Look at Matilda.
See, there's where that dog is. Should be muzzled. That's a vicious animal. That's a vicious dog. There's state laws, local laws, county laws, jurisdictions that should go into effect. Look, get that her. Dog muzzled.
Look at her. She almost had spite. Finally, Jimmy Hart running for his life, and Matilda is coming after him.
How come you're not addressing me when I say that dog is a vicious animal?
Matilda going after Danny Davis right there. She's getting him right on the heels. Matilda, go get him, girl.
All right, fans, here in New York City in the metropolitan area, get ready. Out of Long Island, the Nassau Coliseum, Friday night, May 1st, phenomenal World Wrestling Federation card. British Bulldogs challenging the Hart Foundation. Bret the Hitman Hart, Jim the Anvil Neidhart for the World Tag Team titles. Danny Davis is history. He has been barred from the building. Santana and Reed, Adonis and Beefcake, so many great singles matches. And, of course, a title defense for the brand-new Intercontinental Champion of the World, being challenged by the former champion, Macho Man Randy Savage. You and Ricky Steamboat in a 15-foot-high steel cage, both men incarcerated, nobody in on the inside except the two of you.
Yeah, just me and the dragon, yeah. And that's just incredible right there, because if anybody thinks that we went the limit in WrestleMania 3, they ain't seen nothing yet. And that is nothing compared to what you're going to see in the Nassau Coliseum, man, because I'm going to let my feathers fly. Yeah, I'm going to be sky high, 15 feet up in the air, possibly coming down with a big elbow. Not saying, man, not saying no. Nothing means nothing. And nothing means nothing ever again, yeah. Me the first, and that's all. I get the belt back.
What a fatalistic attitude on the part of Macho Man Randy Savage.
Don't bet against me!
Ladies and gentlemen, the superstars of wrestling to join us. One of the most exciting tag team combinations in the world today. Yes, it's Rick Martel and Tom Zink. Also to join us, by the way, the King, Harley Race, along with this man, Hacksaw Jim Duggan. And then from there, the awesome tag team combination of Kamala and Sika, now managed by Mr. Fuji. And yes, Jake the Snake Roberts. All of that and more next week, right here on the Superstars of Wrestling.